Grim news out of Ukraine. A Russian airstrike hit a children's hospital in the city of Mariupol. Patients, including women in labor, trapped under the rubble. The White House calls Moscow's move barbaric. Here's the full story.
Ukraine on Wednesday said a Russian airstrike badly damaged a children's hospital in the besieged city of Mariupol, burying patients under rubble and injuring women in labor. Video shot by the Ukraine military of what appeared to be the badly damaged children's and maternity hospital showed the wreckage of a three-story building. Piles of rubble and burnt-out cars were seen smoldering outside, and wounded people were carried from the destruction. Video posted on Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky's Instagram account showed the hospital interior piled with debris from broken windows, walls, and equipment. The bombing, which Zelensky called an atrocity, took place despite an agreed ceasefire to enable thousands of civilians trapped in the city to escape. The Kremlin denies targeting civilians. The White House condemned the assault. Press Secretary Jen Psaki.
It is horrifying to see the type of the barbaric use of military force to go after innocent civilians in a sovereign country.
Ukraine said 67 children across the country had been killed since the invasion, and more than 1,000 civilians had died in Mariupol. It was not possible to independently verify the figures. More than 2 million people have fled Ukraine since Russian President Vladimir Putin launched the invasion on February 24th. Ukraine continues to call for allies to imply a no-fly zone, but NATO has declined that request, fearing it could escalate the war. And on Wednesday, the Pentagon closed the door on Poland's proposal to put its MiG-29 fighter jets at the disposal of a U.S. military base in Germany in response to Ukraine's call for fighter jets. Pentagon spokesman John Kirby said the plan was not tenable.
The intelligence community has assessed that the transfer of MiG-29s to Ukraine may be mistaken as escalatory and could result in a significant Russian reaction that might increase the prospects of a military escalation with NATO.
Moscow says its demands, including that Kyiv takes a neutral position and drops aspirations of joining the NATO alliance, must be met for it to end its assault.
Ukraine's capital now encircled by Russian forces, but the governor of the Kyiv region vows to fight to the death before allowing Russian forces to take their homeland. We have this report.
New recruits to Ukraine's territorial defense forces in Kyiv got a lesson on Wednesday in newly arrived weaponry meant to punch a hole through a Russian tank. And this instructor, who only gave his name as Alex, told Reuters these men were ready to welcome the Russian army when it tries to take the city.
Russians can enter Kyiv, but they're not going to leave it. They're all going to burn up here.
Many expected Kyiv to quickly fall in the early days of the war. But 2 weeks into the Russian invasion, which Moscow calls a special military operation, Moscow's military missteps and tenacious Ukrainian resistance has kept the capital from changing hands.
Of course, we understand and see that the enemy wants to seize Kyiv. We understand that very well.
Oleksiy Kuleba is the governor of the Kyiv region.
Of course, they were not able to seize Kyiv immediately. Their aim was to do so in 2 or 3 days. This is a well-known fact. They failed because of the heroic actions of our armed forces and ordinary people who stood up to defend our city, our country.
He spoke to Reuters about the struggle ahead in almost apocalyptic terms.
For us, this is Judgment Day. It is a struggle between good and evil. And either way, we would die, but we would not let them seize our city.
Sounds and symbols of Ukrainian resolve spring up around the city. On Wednesday, the remaining musicians of the Kyiv Classic Symphony Orchestra performed the Ukrainian and European Union anthems. The show was broadcast live on Ukrainian TV. The conductor called the concert an action for peace. That is the message here. Praying for peace.
Слава Україні!
Героям слава!
Preparing for battle.